As we begin the new year, if there's one thing I can tell you with certainty, it's that rental prices in Hudson County have gone wild and it's only getting started. So let's buckle up for what is shaping up to be a fireworks display of a market in 2022. Well, as we celebrate New Year's, the mainstream media will bless us with some new fears, from Omicron infections to the Fed tapering directions. We should all know by now, it's all motivated by the midterm elections. So I'm going to cut through the misinformation and continue to provide you with the most accurate truth about the state of the real estate sales and rental markets in 2022. We'll start off by discussing what I'm seeing as boots on the ground in terms of rentals, then what this means for the sales markets. You see, in December, I had a couple of rental units come available. Generally speaking, I'm not a big fan of listing properties for sale or rent in December. However, these are long-term rental clients of mine, so we positioned their leases to reset on February 1st, giving us ample time to replace the current tenants. Now, I did this because I've made so many mistakes over the years that I've learned that late November and December markets are a bit unpredictable, and having a vacancy turnover on December 31st, New Year's Eve, it's always a disaster for everybody involved. So that explains the February 1st dates, which is no surprise if you're a client of mine. However, what was surprising was that in just 48 hours of listing these homes for rent, both units had multiple offers from renters that had fantastic credentials. We're talking top tier credit and top tier income. I've been working with both of these landlords for over a decade, and both of these homes rented at record high prices, by far the highest we've ever rented them for, in what I usually consider to be the worst month to be on the market. So what made this more interesting was that one of the homes that we rented, we also rented last year at the same time. And due to market conditions at that time, we were forced to rent at the lowest price we had ever rented in 11 years. So when applying last year's rate to this year's rate, we've seen a 22% increase. Now, if you watch any of my videos in the past 3 or 4 months, you'd recall I've been talking about how I felt rental rates in Hudson County were going to spike by the end of the year. In October, I pointed out that the shortage of rentals in New York City was going to have a big impact on us. Businesses are now demanding that workers come back to work physically and not just remotely. And this is where the supply shock has occurred in the New York City rental market already. Now, when this happens, the next logical step in the market is a shortage in Hudson County. So let's take this one step further. We can take this information presented to us and use it as a tool to predict where the market's going. This is why I'm always a huge proponent of being 1 quarter ahead of the competition, because by the time that prices start changing, the competition has already grown considerably. But it's not too late. There's still a lot of fear holding back the retail investment market in terms of real estate. Concerns over Omicron, inflation rates increasing, Fed interest rate hikes in 2022, as well as employment shortfalls in the near term. All these things are scary on the surface. However, I feel as though it's time to take the calculated risk. Certain key metrics have already played out. Some of the cards are already on the table for us to see. So to show you this, I'll bring you back to a video I made in June talking about how time was running out on discounted rentals and sales prices in Hudson County.
Sales in New York City are down 28% year over year, but that's already changing. And I'm gonna show you why that's gonna happen really fast. And a lot of buyers and renters are about to miss out on a big opportunity in the next 90 to 120 days.
Now, I'm not gonna sit here and act like I'm Nostradamus. My timing wasn't perfect, but timing the market will never be perfect. So getting close is all you need to have a major win. So to help define the significance behind the current rental market increases, I'll draw your attention back to the same video where I used a sample property as an example on how inflation will cause current rental rates to rise and in turn, sales prices to climb as well. Because while some prices may have seemed high in June, applying the current increases of rental values, the June prices are already seeming to be valid. In the case of the property I was using as an example, the asking price was high using the current rental valuations at that time. However, if the rental market increased, well, then that price wouldn't be so bad. Here's a 40-second snippet just for your reference.
Now back to the subject property that I think poses the perfect example of what's about to happen in this market that's coming up and why a lot of investors are missing out if they're not working with agents that are in tune with the direction in which the market's going. So this home is a four family, which means it has four units, and we're looking to sell it just under 1.1 million. Now the feedback that we've been getting is that people are looking for a 5% cap rate or higher, and where we're currently priced at gives us about a 4% cap. So we have two options. We can either bring the price down to about 900,000, or rents would have to go up about 15% to get us to that 5-6% cap, which in my opinion, based off of the information I'm going to share with you, is pretty much a given at this point.
Now, here's the caveat. That same property won't sell for 1.1 million in today's market. There's just too much fear, as I previously stated. However, the numbers to support the price are already valid. So again, I've said this before, the seasoned investors that always seem to win are the ones who buy first when others are too scared. They aren't necessarily fixated at buying the bottom. They're more focused on using metrics like inflation data to hedge their bets on where they think the market's going next. And judging by where rentals are going right now, the sales market is about to follow suit. And the only thing that will slow this down are a few rate hikes, but that won't stop the overall market from increasing because the inventory shortage will still remain. So, as always, I hope this was helpful to you or somebody that you know. Let's get ready for an amazing 2022 in terms of real estate, and always call, text, or email if you have any questions. As always, thank you again for watching, and I'll talk to you soon.